Apple iPhone. Now, if you are a cell phone carrying human, like I just looked the statistic up the other day, 90% of the households in the United States, you might understand that waiting 2 years for that cell phone upgrade can be agony. It's all great in the beginning, right? Your phone is shiny and new. Then a couple months go by, and the inevitable, you drop it. If you're lucky, it's just on the ground. And if you're not, it might be somewhere like the toilet or the garbage disposal. And it doesn't just happen one time. It seems to happen over and over again, every time you seem to touch it. It's slipperier than a greased pig, and with every drop, a new scratch. And then the face cracks, and then it stops charging. And then after a while, it can't even keep a signal. And you have to wait. You have to wait for the new one because you were too cheap to pay the $5 monthly insurance charge. You have to wait because you can't afford the $300 price tag of a new cell phone. So you wait for the 2-year anniversary, for your discounted upgrade, to be liberated from the confines of your lifeless cell phone that keep you connected rest of the world. And so it is no surprise that when that box arrives, you jump for joy and praise God from whom all blessings flow. If only everything in life could be so easy, so nicely boxed with all the answers arriving the day after you ask them. If only life could always bring such hope in a small package. If only life were like the Staples easy button and we could always boldly proclaim after any complicated task, that was easy. This morning, we stumble upon the scene of Moses tending to his father-in-law's sheep. Life has never been necessarily simple for Moses, but then life never is. But Moses has had his fair share of complications. As a baby, he escapes Pharaoh's sword when his mom places him in a basket down the bulrushes of the Nile. He dodges death and is raised by Pharaoh's daughter in the royal family. And as a young man, he flees Midian after killing an Egyptian who mistreats the Hebrew people. But now life is a bit more settled. Now Moses finds himself quite comfortable with a wife and a family, a good job shepherding his father-in-law's sheep. Life is good. It's quite good. It really couldn't get any better. So when God comes speaking in God-like ways, Moses is sure to contain his excitement. In a flame of fire out of Kodesh, God speaks to Moses. I have observed the misery of my people who are in Egypt, Moses. I have heard their cry. I know their sufferings. Moses, I will send you to Pharaoh to bring my people out of Egypt. we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. So First Christian Church Lynchburg, who are you? What characteristics are in you? What distinctive talents and passion and wisdom and creativity do you bring to the world? As a child of God, what will you make manifest? And let's just pause, because while we are acknowledging all of our gifts and talents, let's be honest with ourselves and acknowledge all of the questions and all of the fears and the concerns and the anxieties and the frustrations and the fatigue and the quirks. Let's name them and bring them with us. Let's embrace them and stop pretending that they are not there and that we're perfect, because we're not fooling ourselves, we're not fooling each other, and we're sure not fooling God. I know it would be nice to have all the questions to our life, to the church, to God, in a pre-packaged box of answers. But the downside to boxes is that, well, they box us in. They rob us of life. They anesthetize us. They limit us. They blind us. Boxes, after all, are what they bury us in. So who wants to be limited to a box? There is no simple box of answers. There is no Staples easy button. There is no magic box. We live in a wonderful mystery of God. A God that calls, a God that provides, a God that sustains, a God of abundance that creates and recreates, a God that reveals but does not always reveal everything, or at least not in the timetable that we are provided for living, and a God that is with us. Who am I that I should go? Asked Moses. I will be with you, God assures him. I will be with you. While we struggle with the questions and the fears and realities of our own life, may we also find comfort in a God that always responds with, I will be with you. May we trust that God will give energy to our passion and the heart and soul to pursue our talents. May God bless you, First Christian.